Welcome one, welcome all, welcome. We are here again. The beautiful Serene Republic. The Venetian Balkans, as you can see. We are, again, still trying to get as high a score as possible with Venice, while keeping it as a merchant republic. One of the key ways of doing that is to massively abuse their trade bonuses, and one of the ways we're doing that is we're planning to take control of the Alexandrian trade node, and pump as much of the trade from the Eastern Asian empires in the East Indies through the Gulf of Aden up through Alexandria instead of around Africa and into, well, the English Channel, where it went historically thanks to the Dutch and the English. We are going to attempt to make that not happen in this game. And we've already achieved a very important piece of that goal. We have taken control of the river delta around the Nile, almost all of it, anyway. And soon we will grab the last trio of provinces that we need to make this a reality. We need to get essentially a port on the Red Sea here. But in order to do that, we had to break the back of the Mamluks. We've almost done it. The vast majority of the Mamluks' development was in this little area here, you can see. Once I grab Cairo and Damietta, then we'll be in a very good shape. Aleppo, Hama, and Damascus are still pretty good for them. You can see they're at least 20, that's why they're yellow. And we may try to take those eventually, but this was the key area here. At least for us. Meanwhile, we also would love to continue finishing off the Ottomans in order to get deeper control over the Constantinople trade node. Unfortunately, the Russians allied with the Ottomans a mere year before we were planning to ally with the Russians, and now we can't ally with the Russians because the Ottomans are our rival. And we can't attack the Ottomans because the Russians will come to get us. And the last time when the French came to get us, the French being in charge of Hungary due to a lucky inheritance, apparently, well, the Poles did not come to our aid. We went deep into debt just to get a white piece out of them, but we managed to do it. And now we're paying that debt off. Where are we left? Two more loans to pay off, and then we'll be back in business. But the Poles abandon us. Poland and Lithuania could easily have helped us win the war against the French and their allies. Naples was involved in that, as was Savoy and Spain. And we did have Austria and Great Britain join us for that war, but it wasn't hugely helpful. I mean, look, Poland even has a lot of trust in me, and yet they broke their trust. Let us hope it will not happen again. I'm still not able to attack the Ottomans. I mean, even with the help of Poland and Austria. Well, maybe with the help of Poland and Austria. Poland will probably go toe-to-toe with Russia. Because they've got Lithuania as well. They will probably eventually peace out, though. I'm not sure. I mean, maybe. I mean, I can take on the Ottomans. You can see they've only got 15,000 men here, and that's probably the extent of their forces. Nope, not at all. Jesus, they still have 55,000. Even though we've pretty significantly reduced them, they still have a few key valuable territories. Here, 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 up there. Is that their capital now? It is. That's why it's so highly developed. Jesus. Man, I don't know. I don't want to risk attacking the Ottomans and getting involved in Russia only to have the French attack me like they did before, because I could definitely not survive that. So I don't think I can make any offensive moves against the Ottomans or the French without worrying about the other one hitting me from behind. So I kind of am in a waiting game right now. And of course the French are sitting here claiming my territory. We still have our decently sized trade league here. We were going to try to get Albania involved in that. They still don't like us enough. But let's try anyway. We have a ton of territories that we can't make into states because if we did, we would lose a lot of Republican tradition here. How many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. We're exactly at the number we need to be. If we go over this, we start losing Republican tradition at 0.1 per province that is made into a state. And that is why, unfortunately, our force limit is lower than it should be for all this territory that we have, because a lot of these have 75% or higher autonomy, and we're only getting 25% of their development added to our force limit, which is very disappointing. But you know, what we do, we don't just win in the first confrontation. We grind them down. We just keep coming because we have a massive, massive amount of trade income with which to build up a giant war chest before we go to war, and we can afford to mercenary the hell out of our army and just pay our way to victory. That's how we're going to try to do it. And one of the things that we're going to do is to try to, no, not improve relations with the Mamluks. Get out of here. Building a spy network against the Mamluks. The next war against the Mamluks can happen at 1583. But I'm going to be looking for an opportunity over the next several years. We're looking for an opportunity where Russia or France gets involved in another war. If they do that, I can either break the backs of the Ottomans or try to assault France and therefore Hungary. And I might, if I'm very lucky, managed to kick the French out of Hungary after taking some territories in the first war. Now, here's the real question. I'm trying to get Albania. Okay, I need more. That's what I was doing. I was getting claims on the Ottomans. I need Moria. So I'm trying to get all of the ones in the Ragusan trade node that I can, but also the Constantinople trade node that I can. We also need Sulga is another really good one. So is Saruhan. But I don't think we can get Saruhan. Sulga. And we don't have room for another one. Okay. Oh, that's right. We were trying to improve relationship in Ulm to try to get them to join our trade league. And it looks like we can do that right now. There we go. Ulm has now joined our trade league. I mean, they're not huge. They're 19 development. That's not nothing. And more importantly, they're in the Vienna trade node, so they give me a portion of their trade power to help pull trade down towards Venice, which is still currently the highest valued trade node in the world, which is important because that means that we will be the center of global trade. Uh-oh, rebel uprising, the Mamlukian separatists. Well, that's why we have our forces down there, as it happens. We're upgrading Alexandria to a bastion to make it harder to capture. We should probably do the same on some of these other territories that we own. Macedonia is definitely important. We should definitely upgrade that one. And Constantinople gives the enemy a massive amount of war score if they take it, so I want to make sure we get that. I'm now torn on whether or not we should have this as a fort. Because if you do have that as a fort, it means the enemy can move between all of them. But I think just having it as a fort slows them down at least a little bit. Where are other most important areas? We need to make sure Ragusa isn't taken. And Milan is also a very, very high importance. And Treviso will be next, once we make a little bit more money. Death of a merchant. The state needs the money. We can get a bunch of money. Or we can get some prestige, which we have 54. It's decent. Or we can get prestige and a 3-skill philosopher that's cheaper. Because he's well-advised. I like that idea, because that'll save me some money. I'm already getting the prestige from there, so let's do that. Because this guy costs 11, and this guy, Mario Maestra, costs 5.8. Much better. That's a considerable amount of money per month, as long as he stays on for a long time. So we need some causes belli against the Mamluks, which we're trying to work on right now. Okay, so the Albanians finally like us a little bit, and they will join our trade league. Excellent. There we go. So now we have a pretty strong defensive alliance here. Salzburg is willing to join a trade league, maybe? Yeah, but let's get them to like us first. What other cities might we benefit from if we get them to join our trade league? We had Mantua, but unfortunately Mantua has evolved to much... not has evolved. They have grown past the point where they could join a trade league. That's a two-province... I could release Azov as a one-province minor to get it part of the trade league, but I don't really want to. Bessarabia? Is that really a... It's its own nation. How did it get there? Was Poland forced to release it somehow? Because it was part of Moldova. Anyway, we'll gobble it up if we can. Something tells me we won't be able to, though. I mean, we won't really gobble it up. It's just going to be part of our trade league if we get the opportunity. Because it is in a region that would be valuable to us. Ooh, better administration. How's that going to help? We have 3 inflation, so that's quite helpful. We're still trying to convert the rest of our nation over to reformed. The next set of ideas that we get access to, by the way, is going to be exploration ideas until we get quests for the new world. We're going to use it to explore this area over here, then we're going to dump it in favor of something much more valuable to us. Let's see. Wow, we don't get any +2s, huh? Well, we have plenty of money, so let's get a +3 that gives us even more. Yep, we're going to do that. In fact, we're going to upgrade our... this to a +3 that gives us more morale for our armies. And that lowered our income a little bit, but I think getting the extra monarch power is worth it at this particular moment. We have so far been leading. Take Jerusalem and get free money. What does Jerusalem have that gives us free money? I mean, they've got 13 development. It's not bad. I'll get to it eventually, but right now the focus is still to get that Suez area. Looks like we can get another, fabricate another claim on the Ottomans soon. The Mamluks, however, let's... France no longer considers us a rival! This is possibilities! They're endless! Alright, let's get Dimeta. There we go. Boom. Let's try to make France not one of our rivals either. Who can we take instead? Spain, Savoy, Burgundy, Bohemia... Does Austria not like Bohemia? Because I'm kind of worried about Bohemia. Yeah, Austria and Bohemia hate each other, so I want to hate on Bohemia as well. I mean, they're kind of scary right now. Can we not agree on that? That's really scary. And I think I might wind up going to war against Bohemia. Because I think, yes, Poland and Austria both hate them. So that they're in a bad position as far as that's concerned. So I will join in on them being in a bad position. Anyways, this is still growing, mostly because Rosetta is not happy with, well, everything, it seems. I read chat. I just haven't yet. I've been trying to recap everything that's going on here. Keep things moving. So let me see. This is not a mod. Well, I could buy or steal maps, is true. That's how I got most of Ethiopia as it currently is. However, apparently you need to have somebody in a region nearby where you need to steal the maps from. I'm not entirely sure why that's the case. I can give that a shot this game. All right, and Kana would no longer... Oh, we need to re-get that claim against the Papal State because, well, why not? And we should have him returning. Boom. And we're going to get the Saruhan once we get to 45 here, which will happen right now. There we go. We got plenty of claims against the Ottomans now to enforce our will. Let's get rid of all these stupid things we don't need. We don't want to be defender of the faith. We don't need to buy any of that. Let's see. Administrative ideas. Core creation cost is good, but do we need it? Let's keep on our technology as high as possible first. Yeah. Let's see, can we pay back all our loans? We absolutely can pay back all our loans, it looks like. There we go. No more loans to worry about. Now we only have to worry about the uprising that's about to happen here. And we're 7th in military rank, but if we were to start paying for all our forts, we'd still have a good income from 28 to what, 20? 23. If we start paying for all our forts, we then jump from 7th to 5th, so we'll leave it there. 96 Republican tradition. What bonuses does this guy have? Possible advisors. Well advised is nice. We lost our good military advisor. And administrative ideas and offensive ideas are the two that we're trying to balance now. We need to wait for some money to get a better guy here. Let's see. What is our guild situation? The aristocrats are too strong, so let's give some power to the... You know what? Let's give some power to the traders just this time, and then we'll use that extra diplo power. And actually, we're a little bit behind in the diplomatic compared to the other two, so we've been doing okay. National manpower modifier might be the right one to have now. Well, we're almost at our limit. Ooh, let's see. Plague. Look out. The whole world is discoverable. Oh, I'm sorry. You said take Jerusalem for the free missionary. Yes, that is not a bad idea. Although currently my one missionary is doing all that is needed. Aha! There it is. And we will put them down. And probably never have to deal with them again. Because their separatism should be going away by the time the recent uprising thing disappears. Or at least it will be much smaller. Do we have enough to get a decent... Nope, not yet. I'm very unhappy with all of these advisors. There's not a single discipline or morale in the bunch now. And while land force limit, fort defense, land maintenance, national manpower, and reinforced speed are all nice in certain specific situations, I've never been one to like them a whole lot. Damn it, the guilds... I mean, I like gaining stability. Yeah, let's gain some stability. That's very expensive to get when you're talking about getting to level 3. It's quite valuable. Okay. So, the Mamluks kicked us out while we were trying to build a spy network, so let's reestablish that. We've got that. The Papal State is almost ready to get a claim on them. Although they are allied with Bohemia and Spain, so we're probably not going to press this claim anytime soon, but it's good to have options. Mantua went to war with Tuscany. How is that going to shake out? I was thinking if Tuscany gets a little bigger, I'd want them as an ally, because they are crazy strong if they get bigger. So Mantua is attacking Tuscany, and they're bringing Naples into it. And Tuscany only has Siena as an ally. Huh. Well, no, wait a minute. Tuscany doesn't have anybody as an ally. Oh, Tuscany has Naples as an ally. I can't read the damn map. Okay. It's going to cost me the same amount to get rid of these threes and find one that I like. Whoa, hold on. Your horse is here. Austria, second Austrian conquest against Ravensburg. This is the one that you lost horribly last time, Austria. Why do you think it's going to work this time? Oh, because this time maybe they're not going to war against... I think France was involved last time. Who was it? It wasn't France. Maybe it was Bohemia. Yeah, Bohemia was involved last time, and that's why Austria got their ass kicked so badly. But this time is not the same. So we will accept that call to arms as soon as we move our navy up there. I mean our army, rather. Augsburg left our trade league because they're on the other side of this. Oh, and Bohemia did join. It just didn't join right away. Well, Austria, why do you have to be so dumb? Exactly. Where are your forces? How come they disappear from the map sometimes? There they are. They lost a battle. If I'm really your only ally in this war... Jesus, Austria! Why do I even bother with you as an ally? I should have got Bohemia as my ally. Mantua wants military access. Sure, whatever. Neither of those are applicable. We still don't have a decent freaking advisor. I can't do it. I can't pay a ton of money just to find a disciplined advisor. And now, because of this war, my coasts are gonna get raided. Ugh, I hate that so much. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Naples is also involved here. Austria, you're gonna get your ass kicked. Oh my god. And Hungary is somehow also at war with you? Oh, Jesus. I think I need to abandon the Austrian train and find some other train to hook my wagon to. Russia would have been nice, except that they are rivals with Poland, who is the only other heavyweight in my alliance. Here's what we can do. We can maybe go down and deal with Naples. Now, I need to figure out what my army composition should be. If it's combat width of, say, it's 29, but let's say 30, that means we need 15 and a half army. So we'll put all four, and then two. Then we need 13, let's put 3 cavalry and then 12 infantry. All right, so there's a nice half army for us. 12, 3, and 4, so we need two more of these, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we'll need 8 infantry, which we will draw from the ranks. Oh, come on now. Don't be that way. There we go. We will also need a leader. That's a really good leader we've got there. I forgot about him. I'm not sure I even want to try to win this. Did Brescia finish its bastion? It did. Now Treviso also needs a bastion. I don't know if it's going to be finished in time. Uh-oh. Burgundy is also? Holy crap, Austria! What are you doing? How did Burgundy get involved? Are they a great power? Did they weigh in or something? They're not a great power. I have no clue how Burgundy got pulled into this. I mean, Austria is not the current emperor. It's the Palatinate. Palatinate? Which is allied with Burgundy, but how could the Palatinate get involved defending Ravensburg when it's an internal empire matter? Like, the emperor shouldn't get called in, right? Am I missing this? I mean, this is just going to be a super costly war for me. 19,000. And our force limit is 45, so I can only really have two of those. Jeez, it might be too late if this stupid Burgundian force gets too strong. No, no, no. Take the boat like a smart man. Jesus. 51 over there, another 40 over there. I mean, we're losing this. Austria is going to be destroyed by this war. They're going to get 100% war score against them. Now I'm not going to get a cast iron cannon from there, so we have to build one over here. So we'll cancel that one, get some of our money back. Not much. Oh, and we have to cancel whatever's in here, too. Another cannon. That one's changing its culture, maybe, eventually. Oh, that one's leaving now. That's good. Oh, snap. Austria, really? You're going for that? You know there's 32,000 coming in reserve. I mean, I'm gonna trust you here, but I don't think it's going to work out. I mean, we do have the advantage here because of the terrain, right? So there's that. And they don't have a leader. Oh, that's even better. Wow, that actually worked out. Austria pulling the risky maneuver, and it works out for them. We didn't even take any casualties. Austria beat them before we even made it there. All right, I'm going to back off and finish my recruitment. Oh, God. Dimeta's going to be in trouble. It doesn't have a bastion. Truvenia does. No, Travunia. If only I could get a good freaking... All right, I'm going to kick this guy out and try to pay for a good advisor down here. Let's use this to deal with Naples. Our navy is still kicking people's butt. That's good. Alright, come on. Give me a discipline or a morale. There it is. That's what we need. We've already got... What do we have? Do we have any good discipline from any of these things? We didn't finish any of... There's some discipline in the offensive ideas tree. We're not quite there yet. We are saving up in order to get this option, the 15th, which will give us plus one morale. That's massive. That's super important. Can the war last for another 3 years? Are we going to be the first to get that? Let's see. Let's check out the tech level. Austria is at 14? Oh, we're both at 14. Okay. Is anybody involved at 15? No. That's good news. That's the only good news. Naples is actually really far behind, interestingly enough. All right. We're going to put our leader in charge here and send him over to Lika while this waits for the last two culverins to be prepared. The knights are against me in this? How did the knights? The knights are allied with Ravensburg? No, the Palatinate. My own trade league is now ganging up against me. I mean, they can't siege Alexandria, so... That's safe, for now, from them, anyway. Can we go into Hungary? We can. In that case, let's go into Hungary and beat the crap out of Cologne. And then our other 17,000 will come and aid us. We won another battle. That navy is getting pretty beat up, though. I kind of think it needs to go home and heal. I mean, this navy's not doing much right now. Oh, Jesus, look at this. These numbers are too big for me to take on by myself. Uh-oh. I think on the 7th we're going to retreat, because I don't want to deal with this mess. There we go. I didn't mean to run into them up there, but that's what happened. This is one of those times where Austria probably should just give in. Should I get another cavalry here? Just to fill out the numbers properly. Make it look better. Cavalry's still slightly stronger than infantry. And I forgot to do that. Switch over to war. That will help. Oh, we scared them away by being nearby. That's good. The 32... that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to defend my home territory. If they come for me, I'm going to try to fuck them up. I definitely can't get over there to save them, but I don't know. Maybe I'll make my way over there, but I think Burgundy's going to make it before me. Whatever. Oh, they're going the wrong way. So maybe I can... Oh, Austria's already bucked out of there. I'm just going to be looking for opportunities to attack the enemy in the mountains here. Where is my... Is this it? Yeah, hills. There we go. The simplified terrain view can be pretty valuable. Alright. They're here. They keep running away from me. I do outnumber them. And... Oh man, he's got a 2-6, and I've got a 4-4, so we're both going to have a situation where we have a 2 advantage. Give it another tick on the map here. There we go. That's almost fully reinforced. Should I wait one more tick? I can afford to wait another tick. These guys are just going to be taking damage there. I don't have the highest tech at the moment. I will soon. I'll be able to get 15 on all three within the next 2 years. 3 years at most. Here, Austria, this is where you want to come. There we go, we're flanking them. And we're beating them down. Austria, how do you not have a stronger set of alliances? I mean, maybe they did at one point, but they certainly don't now. Uh-oh. Can we intercept them in the hills? That's not good enough. Let's see if we can get them to come to the mountains. I don't want to deal with that Bohemian Palatinadian nonsense. Oh, they're going for it. Okay. Well then. Are you going for it, Austria? Are you? This seems like a mistake. My guys haven't backed up their full morale yet. Okay. Well, their morale is almost maxed out. I'll go with you, but let it be on the record that I think this is a mistake, unless those guys just keep walking away. I'm going to hold these guys in reserve until the timer ticks. Over. Oh, there we go. Okay. We destroyed the whole army! Wow! I should have zoomed in on that. We had good leaders, but I didn't think we'd kill them that quickly. Holy moly. Maybe now I can go down and deal with Naples and get them out of this war. Oh, and this guy. Let's do it the other way around now. No, whatever. Actually, let's send them both this way. That's my 2, that's my 1, that way I can use hotkeys. No, Caramon, you get nothing. You lose. Good day, sir. I freaking love the plus 10% to morale that the fervent focus on war provides. I wish it would let me change what I'm doing. Why won't it let me change what I'm doing? That's really weird. If you're involved in a naval move, it won't let you change what you're doing. No, this is my one. That's my two. I want to find that little army that's running around over here. There they are. I don't know if I'm going to outrun them. He's got a four maneuver. Two maneuver. They're just going to keep... No, damn it. They're going to use those forts to their advantage, I think. Oh, we managed to split off the Cologne army. I don't know if he's going to run out of room to run. There is a mountain range here he won't be able to go through. Where'd he go, though? There he is. Now we caught him. Ha-ha! You're doomed now! Meet your end with dignity. Boom! Punched your ticket. Okay. Austria's now got rebels. Yeah, of course they do. Ah, can we get back here in time? I don't know. No, we don't need to use... There. That gives some weird bugs sometimes. Alright, we can get our military administration. Stay ahead of the game in our technology. Wow, 35,000 Bohemians are down defending Naples. I just want to go kick the Burgundians in the face again. If they give me a good option to peace out because they're pissed that I keep stopping them from doing things, then I'm taking it because Austria's doomed in this game anyway. Or this, well, probably in this game, but also in this war. Let's wait for one tick to get our army back to full strength. Give this a tick as well. 26, 27, 28, 29, 30th. There we go. 1st of July. Go! Damn it. Should have waited till the 2nd of July. We would have got a tick, but it looks like... Yeah, we've got only 105% discipline, but our leader's quite good, and our morale is way higher than theirs. Oh, boy. Oh, we have that full Elon event. I forgot. That's making us awesome. I can't attack the Burgundians now, though, because I need to give myself some time to recuperate. Yes, I know I'm at war. My ports are blockaded. Oh, what are they doing over there? Get them! You go back to doing your thing with the trade. Because so far, that 43 ships has done plenty. Really? Let's bring this guy to bear. Boom. Sunk some guys. There's still those guys to deal with. Ugh. Wow. Okay, well, they're gone. They couldn't decide what they wanted to do, and so they died. Get off of Milan. They are my friends. Yeah, higher tech is better. Damn it, I really don't want Burgundy to take that territory, though. But it looks like they're going to. Because I keep getting distracted by these tiny, easy-to-pick-off forces. And I'm losing over here, too. Utrecht. Alright. Yeah, we lost the Siege of Edirin. Get him before that tick. Yes, okay. We're outflanking them. And that was all it took. Okay, now... Do we get military? Nope. Navy. May sabotage... What did that say? Reputation? Recruitment. I didn't know you could sabotage recruitment. Interesting. Now the Burgundians are sieging down... How did Mantua get added as a... That's weird. They called him in after the other Mantua war was over, I bet. These guys got that as well, huh? Ah, and finally, plus one morale. And charge, infantry. Oh. That's a lot of naval ships, and I think they are probably actual naval ships instead of light ships, which is why they are kind of winning. Yeah, they had a bunch of galleys involved there. But we won the day. We'll retreat to Duras to lick our wounds and... Actually, let's move these guys together. Raiding Constantinople. See, I don't get this. I always let my allies have a bigger spy network because I don't care. Ugh, and now that's happening. Whoa, really? My morale is now freaking insane compared to theirs. Oh, the Elan wore off. That's too bad. But it's still insane. Wait, where did they go? They were right here. They're gone now. Well, the Ottomans attacked and they're now occupying Karaman. They're getting stronger again. That's no good. Can't be allowed. Kill the stupid night ships. I'm tired of them raiding my coasts. I actually don't need to blockade that now that I think about it. Back to protecting trade in Ragusa to pretty significantly increase our income. Whoa, wait a minute. The Austrians got the Bohemians to leave? How? How? Did they occupy a bunch of Bohemia? I didn't even see it. They must have. They couldn't have demanded it if they didn't. That's incredible, Austria. How did you do? I don't even know. Maybe they will win this, despite all. Though I'm running low on manpower. I get 42 of those ducats. Alright. So we need to get up to here to get that back, and then, ugh, look at all this nonsense. Naples won't learn. They keep moving their ships. And they keep losing them. I would like to get Naples out of this stupid war. It's something that's within my power, but if I do that, that's going to keep happening. We can't allow that. Oh, my phone's going crazy here. I forgot I need to leave my boats over here. To blockade Edirne. Now this is a good question. How does this guy... This guy has missionary strength plus one. That's not great. And in fact, if I was going to care about which one I get next, I definitely want offensive ideas. So we're going to get that. The Siege of Alexandria? Fuck you, Naples. I'm pissed. Maybe if I go attack them and deal with their... they don't have enough. I mean, the good news is if I can keep them trapped down there with my ships... Shameful defeat. Mantua is leaving. I mean, I'll take this for occupying 20,000 enemy units. Shipwrecked. Ugh. That hurt. Austria finally ended it, huh? Ah, they didn't lose too much in the end. They just have to pay some penalties. Alright. Now that's the second conquest of that tiny little state that for some reason always pulls in the Emperor, and I still don't understand that. Can somebody explain to me how the Emperor gets pulled into an internal war? I know the Emperor always gets called into external wars. But internal wars have never auto-called the Emperor, in my experience. So that must be new, somehow. Alright. We have to build one new. Those ships... Actually, we need to upgrade those ships, too. And these ships. In order to do that, let's mothball these ships to get us a little bit of a monetary boost. We'll also get rid of all of our mercenaries. And right now we're still, let's check just to make sure. Russia's not at war. France is not at war. So, yeah. Although, that's right, we don't care about... France wants my provinces really badly, but they somehow decided not to be my rival. I'm not sure how that works, but I'm going to butter them up to try to make sure that they are not still rivaling me. Because while I would like nothing more than to get them out of Eastern Europe completely, I'd rather not fight them. So the Mamluks are at war with the Ottomans! Ooh, this is a good opportunity. I can go after the Mamluks from down here, and theoretically they're being drained by the Ottomans right now. 34,000 with 37,000 in reserve? Well, it was too much to hope for. I mean, look, they actually have a lot. How long has that war been going on? Does it say how long that war's been going on? It doesn't really. The defender controls Sivas, though, so I guess the Ottomans have been focused on getting the Karamanis out of the war. Damn it, I don't have the money to upgrade my ships right now. But let's get these guys ready to go. And we'll have 8 infantry, 3 cav. I mean, I've still got the massive morale benefit. I mean, look, these guys aren't even close, right? They're, let's see their tech level. I've got the highest tech level. They're 1 tech level behind militarily, though. And the Ottomans are also 1 tech behind militarily. Okay. So this needs 1 more of that, and then the rest will all be... 2, 3, 4, and then 1. Ay, ay, ay. Hold on. Okay. Let's see. Did I get all of the ones that I needed to here? Yes, okay. So then this has exactly everything I want, except we'll get 1. Probably shouldn't have deleted all of my mercenaries in the end, but I did not see that opportunity with the Mamluks until now. That. All right, 220,000 stacks again. And our manpower reserves are recovering a little bit at least. How's our autonomy down here? Well, it's really high. Slowly going down. Alexandria is actually better than the others. For some reason, Algarbia is really high. All right, we're almost done getting our national unity back up to where it needs to be. Alright, so we're so far ahead here that any new ideas that are available, we will need to take advantage of that. Mercenary maintenance, that's one I want to get to pretty badly. Alright, so we've got 40,000 with very high morale compared to our enemies. I don't know how long that one's going to last. Till 92. A long time. Woo! Nice. All right. This next attack against the Mamluks is probably going to break them. We want Cairo definitely to be a claim. Maybe Gaza and Torreira. I mean, anything on the coast would be good, so that we can get as much coastal territory as possible. Those always have higher trade income automatically. Wow! 30,000 Ottomans are stuck on Cyprus right now. Really? You've got another 30,000 over there that are hiding from the Mamluks because you can't be bothered to just leave some? Never mind. All right, we're keeping our disciplined guy here. The next military idea would be very nice. We're not going to get it for 3 years. We're certainly not going to wait for it. We're going to go right for the Ottoman, or for the Mamluk's heart. Since we can't attack the Ottomans and they're just getting stronger, we have to get stronger too, and that means taking out the Mamluks. If I can get Fayum, I would like to get a claim on that as well. Looks like I will. Booyah! Kasha. Okay. And we've got a ton on the Ottomans. Let's support some rebels for the Ottomans, shall we? Noble rebels are almost always the best to support because they come up strong enough. Although that's only a 17 revolt size. I would like to do particularists only because they almost always are the biggest. Yeah, I'll take a loan and try to support that. Hashtag worth. And now we'll go to war with the Mamluks. Oh, we still have the guy stealing information about the Papal State, so let's use this to get Ancona and Umbria. And then we'll bring him back and use him against the Mamluks. Right? Right. Yeah, exactly. When I say not fight them, I mean destroy them later. That sounds correct. This does not have a leader because we changed him. There we go. Okay, so the first task is going to be subduing Cairo. That will immediately make them upset. Especially if you make that our war target. Conquest of Cairo. We can't bring any of our allies. Morocco is not going to come to their aid. Oh, good. I thought Tunis was their ally, but I guess they're just allied with the Ottomans. So, boom. Neither of these guys have siege... Oh, this guy's a siege specialist, so I guess we'll do that with him. And we'll start sieging down the other areas around here, but I'm going to keep my armies close. I do not want ridiculous things to happen. Like they're popping out of nowhere. They come out of the desert! And they get us. And it looks like the Mamlukian navy is gone. Probably destroyed by the Ottomans. So I'll just sit here blockading all their other territories, which lowers their income, increases their war exhaustion, and makes us quite happy overall. Oh, Mantua joined a trade league. Really? I didn't get the opportunity. Maybe I can get Modena in our trade league. Oh, but we're at war. Damn it. I missed the opportunity to get both of them. Maybe I can sabotage Lubeck's reputation and force them to leave. Tuscany declared war on Ferra, so I guess I don't want them in my trade league now. Good water shortage, yes. Their war exhaustion's already pretty high. I've conquered these little areas so many damn times. Even in this game alone. There we go, we got Cairo. Let's go and get this down here, because Cairo, under our control, will slow them down if they come to stop us, which is great. Well, I should say Cairo and Alexandria. So let's see what our ultimate goal would be. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we had a claim for this one. We can get that one too. That would be great. Mamluks, Ottomans, Hejaz, Iraq, Karaman, and Beha. That looks pretty bad. Looks like no matter what, we're going to get it. So let's take advantage. Just say, screw it. We don't care. You're awful Middle Eastern heathens, and we're going to take all your stuff anyway. We're strong enough to deal with your coalition. Especially after taking all of that. We're going to add Cairo and Fayum as a part of our territory. Oh, hey, come on. You get out of here. This is ours. The Suez is ours. You leave it. Oh, you bastards. Oh, hey, look. The Mamluk army was way over there fighting Morocco? Is that why they haven't taken any losses against the Ottomans? Or something to that effect. Yes, please go kill each other. I'd appreciate it. What? Oh, come on. Ooh, what do we get? What do we get? We get adaptability, better core creation costs. Good timing for that, actually. We're going to be creating a lot of cores soon. Yay, pay off some loans. Alright, we just need this to figure out what it's doing soon. Yeah, we won the siege. Speed things up a little bit since we're about to win a major battle. Monthly fervor. I lose 10 points of fervor. I don't care. I lose 10 points of fervor all the damn time. Go for it! Don't pop up this when I'm about to go to war. Goodbye. You are the weakest link, etc., etc. I think the Ottomans are sieging this province over here. Yeah, they definitely are. I mean, it would be difficult for us to fight the Ottomans right now. Though I wish I could get the Mamluks as a vassal, but that seems way out of reach. Yeah. Because then I could continue this war against the Ottomans and win it without pulling Russia in. So, are the Ottomans allied with anybody? No, just Russia. I can't even attack the Ottomans obliquely and force them to get rid of their alliance with Russia. No, Aleppo's not worth it because almost all of the trade in Aleppo is already leaving Aleppo, and I control territories that it's going to in both directions, so I don't care about Aleppo. It would be nice to have, but it's not nearly crucial. By any definition of the word. Trying to take as much as I can here, but I have a feeling we're not going to be able to finish this war until the Ottomans have decided that they're going to finish it. Ooh. Ponte de Rialto. I've been to that bridge. That's a really cool bridge. Yeah, we'll take the 10 prestige, sure. Alright, you guys just go back here, I guess, and wait. No, we've got some stuff down here you can get. Ah, how many more? One more till we've fully converted our people. We've improved our relations with France as much as possible, and now we have a plus 35. No way they want an alliance, though. They still have a hostile attitude towards us, despite the plus 35. Let's improve our relations. See? Russia wants an alliance. And they're damn close to giving it to us, except that they're allied with the Goram Ottomans. And I'm allied with Poland, which is their rival. We're just star-crossed lovers. We're destined not to be together, apparently. Get maps from the Ottomans. I don't know. Let's see if they have any maps worth getting. Steal maps. I would love to get maps of the Arabian Sea. Hey, there we go. But now I need maps of Arabia. Good call, chat room. Good call. Ooh, yes, yes, yes. Siege ability. I love that plus 20% siege ability. Ooh, and I finished all of my ideas. So land and naval attrition go down, and galley combat ability goes up. Oh, the Ottomans are done. Hold on just one sec. So this is pretty perfect timing, actually, because now, hopefully, my Ottoman peasants will be rising up soon. Only 10%? What the hell am I bothering? You guys, come on. They should have all kinds of overextension and other things. If I were to declare war on the Ottomans, Austria wouldn't do it. Poland would. Great Britain wouldn't, because they don't seem to care. They're not a very valuable ally. Maybe I can get Tuscany as an ally instead. Yeah, I can. Once we get this finished, Tuscany might join me. Although, really, France is the main idea for an ally here. I could not be allied to Great Britain anymore if it means France would join me against the Ottomans slash Russians. That would be awesome. That's definitely the kind of diplomatic maneuvers I'm going to attempt soon. Cyprus is free again, huh? Oh, they're still a vassal of the Mamluks. Well, maybe that's one of the things we can throw into this deal. Release subjects. Cyprus? Yeah! Let's make that part of the deal. We can get Cyprus as part of our trade league again. They're running away. Alright, speeding this up a little more. Alright, so let's continue making France like us. Even if we're already at the max, I don't care. I want to make sure that stays that way. Maintain diplomat in France. Ah, we're finally at 100 Republican tradition, and if I recall, we got a pretty good thing going. Advisor costs, yes. Keep Francesco Zustiniani. Whatever. Keep him. Ooh, yes, please free mercantilism. I would appreciate that. We got to continue building our spy network there. We might steal some maps from the Mamluks of Arabia if we get an opportunity here in a moment. I'll take the hit to my poor administrative power. Really? You're coming to fight me? A last desperate charge? Huh. So here's the question. How did I miscalculate this by 3? Should be 16 wide. So how come we were wider than that? I don't know. I'll have to double check it the next time we go to battle. Oh no, that was our cheap, awesome guy. Alright, they're not quite willing to give me what I want, but maybe once this happens in the next tick, they will. Don't know who you are and don't care. There it is! So they will give me all of these territories. I will core them cheaper, thanks to my previous ideas. They will also release Cyprus. And annul treaties? No, they just have rivalries. Oh, suddenly it's -5. What the hell? I didn't change anything. That's odd. Yep, we're gonna pay for the +3 there. Damn. Sorry, I've got some allergies here. There we go. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Great day in the morning, people. Victory is mine. Well, now that we're at peace, can we get France to ally with us? We can if we're no longer allied with Great Britain, which was the most useless of our allies. Ooh, and before we do anything else, let's quickly see if we can steal some maps about Arabia. No. We have no units in a region adjacent to this one. Yes, we do. We have units in Mashriq. But I guess because they're exiled, it doesn't count. Well, I guess that makes sense. Oh, if we get these guys no longer to be exiled, maybe it will work. No? Oh! Egypt is not considered to be adjacent to Arabia. Damn. Okay. Well, Mashriq it is. So now I have to have units in Mashriq to get access to Persia and Arabia. So that means I need to conquer Gaza in the next attack. It's too bad I didn't grab it this time. Oh well. So that will avoid me having to spend a bunch of diplo power on the exploration. Thanks, guys. All right, anyway, We were waiting for the advisor to get back to break our alliance with useless England. But let's spend our favors first, just to make them trust us a little more before they stop trusting us. Yes! 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 Come on! Come on! Yeah! Boom! Okay, Russia. Bring it. Bring it. I am here. I'm ready. Now we have to wait like 10 years for France. No! We have to wait 30 years. We're really not strong enough. We need to wait 30 years for France to help us out. That's frustrating. But let's get Cyprus in our trade league if we can. Oh, they are not happy with us, so that'll gonna take a little while. Also, we need to see if we can get these guys back in our trade league. Well, we can stop really making France love us now. And we can stop... Well, no, we probably shouldn't stop doing that, but that's okay. Let's go back to that later. Who else did we lose as part of that trade league situation? Salzburg is at war, so we can't invite them. Mantua is in another trade league. Modena is at war. A subject. And we're trying to get Cyprus. We've already... Oh no, Alania must have left our trade league because now they're too big. That's too bad. Well, France has a bunch of the territory in the Constantinople trade node for some reason. But they're not collecting from it, so at least they're not really using it much. Bessarabia would be an easy place to attack, right? They do have... I mean, here's the thing, though. You know that that is... No, really, it's not considered important to Poland. Okay, well now it's considered important to me. There we go, that's what I wanted to get soon enough. And this one. Dang it. Mogadishu, also very important to me. So we're gonna go fight down there. What's the current technology level like down there? Ethiopia is at 11. That's good. We're gonna have a pretty significant advantage over them if we go after them soonish. But we have to fight another war with the Mamluks to get down there. All right, so right now we're on rest and relaxation duty. What's our mission even? Oh, reduce overextension, that's easy. Booyah. I wish you were not in Lublik's trade node, damn it. I don't want Austria to stop liking me, but now that I have France, I probably don't need you, Austria. Well, at least they're not at each other's throats, so I'll hold on to Austria regardless. They might still be a valuable ally if we have to take on Russia and the Ottomans together. Which we will in 30 years, for fuck's sake. We'll be able to fight the Mamluks again probably before then. 1601, yep. Don't really know what that's going to accomplish right now. Anyway, Bessarabia has no allies, and as soon as we get to 20, I'm going to declare war on them. Italy isn't a country yet, much less have a navy. The French Balkans happened in a very unusual situation. The France has a personal union with Hungary, and so they were able to core territory adjacent to Hungary when the Ottomans tried to fight the Hungarians or something like that. Ooh, Bohemia is getting beat the hell up. This is a time for you, Austria, to go after Ravensburg, all right? This is the moment. You don't go after it when Bohemia is strong. You go after it when Bohemia is weak. That's just how it goes. Oh, you know what? Now I remember the other thing that I wanted to get from the Ottomans. I wanted Kaffa. Bohemia is building a spy network on us. Everybody's building a spy network on us because we are superior in terms of, in terms of tech. Ooh, yes. Land force limit modifier, finally! We're gonna go from 48 to what, 55, 56? 57, okay. That's a pretty significant boost. And then this is going to be... I probably shouldn't bother coring this, actually, because I plan to do this. Turning Razgarib into a trade city. Yeah, that's a nice thing. Boom. Because it's in the same area as Cairo and Fame, and I don't want it to be part of a state because it's awful. Whereas I do want these two to be part of a state. Look at this, is just a giant farmland here. It's awesome. Still a little ways away from our capital, but that's fine. Yep, we're now a large merchant republic, which is going to cause us penalties until we do this. Oh, well, that's not enough, huh? Euboea doesn't need to be a state either. Barely any development there. There we go, we got rid of it. Okay. I think we can add one more state. It's not going to be Azov. It might be Kaffa? Or Burgas. Burgas is a nice little grasslands area, if we ever take it from the French. Or Biga. Yeah, Biga would be another good one. Or Sulga. Don't know. It's going to take a while. The game knows. It's playing us the awesome... war music. Conquer Cyprus, protect brethren and something, protect against Bohemia. Well, I could definitely do that. Now that my force limit is increased. And cannons are going to be increasingly important. So let's do it. No, admin tech doesn't help with the Merchant Republic thing. The Merchant Republic is... issue is that for every province that is part of a state above 20 provinces, you take a minus 0.1 to your republican tradition. Thriving arms industry. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed I did. I would like our manpower reserves to recover, but I'm about to start a war with the Bessarabia there, so that's not going to happen. And I'm trying to save up to improve all my ships. That's going to cost a lot of money. 800 for that fleet. And 500 for that fleet. There goes that giant war. Cyprus can't be any better. We've got the... Whoa, boy. Okay. Bring back the other forces. I didn't know that revolt was going to be quite so big. I want my good general over here. Ah, trade league from Cyprus. Excellent. All right, we'll go and take care of these peasant uprisings. I could really use that money, and I don't want the stability hit, so it is what it is. Means we're not going to be able to keep this leader around quite as long as I might have wanted, but oh well. Don't want that. Alright, I do have enough to get my trade fleet upgraded, which is going to increase my trade power pretty significantly. Once you're done repairing, then you'll go trade in Ragusa. So we've 46 right now. Let's see what happens once it's improved. Yeah, Bessarabia is probably going to be a territory. Really, I'm taking it just to make sure that nobody else has this estuary and using it against me. Right now, they are actually sitting and gobbling up 1.2 ducats per month. That can't be allowed. Oh, wow, it took the Ottomans a long time to get the printing press. Still hasn't made its way down to Ethiopia. So we're starting to get our European advantage over the East and the African, sub-Saharan African territories. Yeah, we've almost finished demolishing the Mamluks. I should actually update that very soon. One more war with the Mamluks and we'll have that done. At that point, we still want to dismantle the Ottomans. They're still too damn strong. But at that point, our new goal is going to be expanding into Ethiopia and getting the trade areas here. That means this province, the Gulf of Aden province, and then the coastal center of trade down here, Mogadishu. If we get those three, then our next goal is going to be expanding over here, and then expanding over here, and then over here, etc., etc. We're going to go further and further and try to pull more and more trade up towards us through the Alexandrian trade node. Alexandrian? Oh, I would have to go on the side of... Wait a minute, Russia's at war against Denmark and Poland? Which also means they're in a war against Sweden. Somehow. Oh, because is Sweden still... Oh, yeah, it still has personal union under Denmark. That's great. That means I might be able to declare war on the Ottomans soon without the Russians coming. Right now, they will, but that's going to keep getting worse as they maybe, hopefully, start losing the war with Sweden. Either way, when the war's about halfway done, I'm going to be jumping in there against the Ottomans. It's going to happen. Let's get Bessarabia now first. The Ottomans still have a massive army, though. And unfortunately, Poland is at war with Russia already, so I'm only going to have Austria backing me up against the Ottomans. Did I want an alliance with Tuscany? I think I did. They are going to be pretty damn powerful. And I want them to counter Savoy if I ever have to deal with that. Naples actually wants an alliance, too. Huh. Everybody wants an alliance with me. I'm not sure I want an alliance with Naples, though. I've already hit my limit. gone over it, actually. I could drop my Polish alliance or just, I don't know. I'm just going to hold on to this way for a while. I do have a massive diplomatic income. We're definitely going to keep Francesco. So I can afford the minus one in order to get a slightly better alliance set up for us. Okay, here it is. Bessarabia. Fabricate claim. Boom, boom. And then declare war. We can't pull any allies with us, but that's fine because they're tiny and they have no allies of their own. Treviso, more manpower would be great, I think. I don't want one base production because they're only producing grain. Yeah, let's do base manpower. Booyah. The Ottomans are at war? Oh, the Ottomans are also in the war against Poland and Denmark, so they will be weakened, and their armies will be far away. Yeah, if I can get Austria to join me in a war against the Ottomans right now, I think we could win it. Especially if Moscow doesn't join, or Russia doesn't join. We'll see. We'll give it a year or two and see where it lies. If Russia's winning, that wouldn't be good. But if they're losing, they won't join the war against me. That's the only hopeful news there. What do we got? What do we got? What do we got? Trade efficiency up. I think we want to hold off until that's cheaper. Instead, let's spend a little bit more power increasing our mercantilism, which is already incredibly high. Let's just make it better. I should probably annex this whole thing and then just turn this part into a trading city. No, I already have one in Ragusa, I think. No, I don't. But I was going to make Valor one. Yeah, so I'll just annex the part that I care about and make it. Or the whole thing, because it is in Ragusa. I might as well just annex the whole thing. As long as it doesn't give me too much aggressive expansion up here, which I doubt that it would. I'll give you a big tutorial on trade in a second here, Streisel. Let me just finish this war. The Mamluks and Hejaz. The only reason not to take both of these is if there was too much aggressive expansion and if it was going to cause an issue with my allies. They don't even care about that. Make Spain like us? Is that possible? It is. Trade is the key to my current success, so it is very important. Cruelty of mercenaries, aww. Will prevent it from happening in the future. Oh, I have no... Okay. Let's stop improving our relationship with Tuscany. We will end this the way that I wanted to. Boom. Ooh, we can't core that one until that one's done. That's fine. Where are we vis-a-vis military ideas? Yes. I want that discipline. And it's coming real soon. Ooh. Russia looks like they're winning this. Now, what is this? It's the conquest of Finnmark? Where the hell is Finnmark? Wow. Interesting. Never knew that was a thing. So far they haven't gotten it, looks like. I think before I go to war with the Ottomans, I want to make my main battle fleet combat ready as well. In order to do that, I'm gonna have to take a loan, I think. How many loans do we have? One loan. Man, our manpower is just not that high. It's always bugging me. Alright, so trade. We're gonna let things slowly move here. I mean, I wish I could see... what's the right time? So first thing. Will Austria join me? France will join me for territory? Really? Huh. Austria won't join me because they're dicks? What's the deal? They're in debt. And they like the Ottomans? Really? What the hell use are you, Austria, if you don't hate the Ottomans like me? Alright, what territories does France want? They want all that for some reason? To what end? Huh. I really don't know if I want France to become that much stronger, but... I could give them one of these territories. Like Bolu. I'd give them these two. I don't really care too much about those. Except I really want to make that copper be valuable. Ugh. If I give them more territory in the Constantinople trade node, they are likely to try to take from it. I almost think, like, I have to do this on my own. So the real question is, and the other thing I wanted to check on this screen and forgot to, Russia's still gonna join, but look, it's actually getting pretty low. For some reason, they like me. Their attitude towards me is good, so they don't want to join a war against me. So I will just wait it out. If Russia loses this +7, if they go down below 0 and won't join the war, I will immediately declare war on the Ottomans. That's the key here. Well, let's see. Austria's... That's the opinion of Ottomans is 52. The Ottomans do have historical rival, but apparently they're improving each other's relations. They're trying to become allies for some reason. Actually, I should stay up here, shouldn't I? All right, so trade. Trade is a complicated thing that makes tons of sense once you understand it. So first thing to understand, you've got all these different trade goods that are being produced. You can click on one, you can see, okay, wine is produced in all these territories. What is this, linen? Linen cloth is being produced in all these territories. A very valuable version of cloth, silk, is being produced in two very, very specific territories, and then in far more in the Middle East and in Asia. Copper is very valuable as well. Salt is okay. Well, wool is meh. It's a 2. You can see here, 2 is not so great. Naval supplies is only a 2. So yeah, cloth is pretty valuable. Gold is great. Gold is not part of the trade system, though, so I'm going to ignore that for now. Wine is, let's see, wine is okay. 2.5, it's okay. Ah, spices down here in Alexandria. Very valuable later in the game. The prices of these things, by the way, change based on events. So you'll see an event that pops up and says, ah, well, artillery is now becoming a big thing, so copper is becoming much more valuable. That's why copper is as valuable as it is right now. It's because of the event that caused it to be valuable once artillery became part of the thing. Eventually, fish might become less valuable. There's an event that says, like, oh, they found the Great Western Banks of America has a lot of really, really good and easy to catch fish. So fish flood the market, but salt goes up because if fish are more plentiful, salt is needed more in order to make them safe to eat from farther away. So that all happens, right? All of these things are being produced and they're all contributing trade value to the system. So here, cotton has a current price of 3 ducats. That means every 1 cotton produced gives you 3 ducats added to that trade node per year. So it's divided by 12 in order to take 3 divided by 12, and it's that many per month added per year per good produced. However, you can see that this province actually is producing 2.66 cotton. So it is actually producing, what is that, 2.5 × 3, 6+, so about 10 ducats per year. So that's a little less than 1 per month from this province is being added to the Constantinople trade node, right? So all of these things are producing trade value according to A, the price of the good times the amount of goods produced divided by 12. Okay, you follow? Does that make sense? That's what it's showing here. The trade value actually is 7.99. Yeah, that makes a lot more sense than my 10. Sorry, bad math. So that's the trade value per year. So divide that by 12, and that's how much is adding from this province. If we go to the actual trade node system and we look, you can see that locally being produced, where was that? That was Saruhan. So if we look on here for Saruhan, it's near the top, 0.66. You can see, yes, yearly it produces 7.99. Divide that by 12, and you get 2/3 of a ducat per month getting added to this node from that province. But you take all the provinces, add them all together, they're all adding 11 trade value into this node. Now, what happens to that 11? That's a good question. The 11 that get added locally is then combined with any incoming trade, like this 3 here coming from the Crimean node, and the 219 coming from the Aleppo node, and the 0.78 coming from the Alexandrian node. All those come in here and are getting combined in this value, plus this value. Then you take a look and you see who's got trade power here, because that determines what happens to that money. So let's look at the easiest choice here. The Ottomans control 32% of the trade here, and that's this number, 183. You take all these numbers, add them up together, divide 183 by the total, and you get 32%. So the Ottomans get to determine, okay, 32% of this trade is staying here in this node. And anybody else in this node, it looks like also the Knights and Karaman also have their trade capital inside the Constantinople trade node. You can see the Knights are green and the Karaman's capital here is green. So they are also trying to keep the trade in Constantinople so that they can collect from it. The other people in this node are trying to pull it on, move it forward. And the only outgoing trade node here is this one, which goes to Ragusa. So that's what this left-hand pie chart means. It means that 37% of the total trade power is trying to keep trade here, which means 37% of this total value, what is that? That's 6 plus 11, so 17-ish. So 37% of that 17 is staying in Constantinople, and it's divvied up amongst all three of the countries that are trying to keep it, Ottomans, Knights, and Karaman. So that's why the Ottomans get, what is it, the base here, 5.56, and then the Knights get 4.48, and the Karaman gets 0.37. But why does it say the Ottomans actually are collecting 10? Well, that's another layer on top of this, because you take the 5.56 and you multiply it by their trade efficiency, so that's an extra 80% on top. So you take the 5.56 times 1.8, and the total is 10.01. So that's how much they actually make. So the higher their trade efficiency is, the bigger the multiplier to whatever they keep. The more that they keep in the node, the better they'll get as well. So those two things help determine that a lot. Now, of the trade here that's getting pulled along, you can see 63% of this 17 is being pulled along. So that pulls 10 forward. Now, that 10.84 gets multiplied by the merchants who are steering it. So Albania and Wallachia each have a merchant in this node, and they are pulling trade in the direction of Ragusa. Now, that would be much more important if there were two outgoing nodes from Constantinople. There's only one. Let's look at a different example. Up here in the Crimea, you can see that there are two different directions, and the majority of it is going north towards Kiev, and about two-thirds is going north to Kiev, and about one-third is going towards Constantinople. Very, very little is staying in the Crimean node. Let's take a look at that. You can see that 97% of the trade power in this node is trying to pull it forward. There's only one country trying to keep it, Alania. That tiny little country over here is trying to keep the trade power here. Nobody else is collecting in the Crimean node. They're all trying to pull it forward. And what you can see here is that Lithuania, Poland, and the Lenovan Order are all trying to pull it north. And they are getting a stronger pull because they have more total trade power here. You can see Lithuania, Lenovan Order, and Poland make up a little more than half of the total power, and they're pulling it north. And they probably have a bonus to trade steering as well that makes their pulls stronger than the pull of the Ottomans, the Knights, the Wallachians, the Karamans, and the Albanians that are pulling it this way. But overall, these guys have less trade power than those guys combined. And so that's kind of why the trade is getting split up the way it is. For my purposes, I have taken over all the important trade, coastal centers of trade that I could in the Constantinople trade node, including the most recent one in the Danube estuary, Bessarabia. So that means that is the reason why, if we look at this trade node, I have so much more power than anybody else. It's because all of my power comes from provincial trade power. Each of the provinces I control has their own trade power that they're allowing to let me choose what happens to the trade here. And if we look, you can see most provinces are around 6. If they're very wealthy, they can get up near 10. But the less wealthy ones will be down near 5. And then Constantinople is at 100 because it's got 3 boosts to its base value, plus all of my bonuses from the buildings that's here, my mercantilism, etc., etc. So I have a significant portion, 57% of the total trade power here, and I'm moving it on to Ragusa. Now, in Ragusa, you get one more piece of trade, which is not only do I have very good provincial trade power, because I have control of Ragusa and Duras, which both have some basic boosts to their trade value with these little circle squares here. I also have a large number of light ships that are escorting the trade towards me. So they know if they come towards me that they'll be safer from pirates, I guess, is the idea there, something to that effect. So I can keep adding light ships to this to keep pulling more and more of the trade towards me, towards the Venetian node. Unfortunately, there's another aspect to this called caravan trade power, which if we look in our trade screen here, you can see what my caravan trade power is. Inland bonus is what it's called. So the higher your development, the higher this bonus up to a cap. The cap is 50. So tiny one-province nations will have a small amount of inland trade power, but if you're big, then you can have a lot. So what this means is, if you're in an inland node, or you're pulling towards an inland node, your merchant applies this much trade power. If you're in a coastal node, your merchant applies 2. So it's a big difference between 2 and 50. The idea being that you'll make up the difference in 2 by providing a bunch of light ships to help pull your trade in a specific direction. This was to make up the gap in trade power between coastal nations and inland nations that were trying to pull trade towards them. But what that means is that even though I have 50% of the trade power here, even though I had control most of the territory, the reason that Hungary, Austria, Bohemia, Trier, and Magdeburg are able to pull so much trade power this way is because they are pulling towards an inland node, so their merchant gets a bonus to his pull. So that's why they're pulling so much here. I have to do a lot more to control of this node in order to get to offset their bonus from the caravan trade power. Even so, they're pulling 7 this way, and I've got a dude here using my caravan trade power to steer it back down towards me. So in essence, I've been able to siphon a bunch of their trade back there. If I get more merchants, it would behoove me to potentially look at where I want to put them. If I put them in the Constantinople trade node, well, that's really not going to do anything because all of my power is already forcing it out this one way. That's all. It's just trying to send it out this way. The only thing adding a merchant here would do would boost this value a little bit. You can see the first merchant increases the value by 5.4, the second one by 2.5, and then it keeps going down. You get diminishing returns for the number of merchants boosting. But the idea there is that if you have a massive empire and you have a merchant here that increases the trade value to there and increases the trade value to there and increases the trade value to here, to here, to here, to here, to here, that is a merchant compounding their interest, plus 5%, plus 5% on top of that, 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 percent of that. So that is how you get the new world to send massive amounts of awesome trade back to the old world, as you can compound that interest as it's coming up. Also, there's just a lot of territories producing things over there, which does have an effect. So all that is why I currently have controlled the specific areas that I want. I have 50% of the Alexandrian trade node because I took care of, took over Alexandria and Rosetta, the two very important territories there. I will eventually get to Aleppo so that I can force more of that local trade out. Now, I don't have a merchant in Aleppo, so my power, the power that I control in Aleppo, which it looks like it's about 32%, is actually forcing trade equally in both directions. If I put a merchant here, I could steer trade in a specific direction, which is actually what I might want to do in Crimea. If I get another merchant, I might put it in Crimea to steer it towards Constantinople, because right now my trade is steering it in both directions, unfortunately. And the last piece to this is if you put a merchant in your capital where you're collecting trade, he just increases your trade efficiency by 10%. So basically, he increases my trade by 3.2 ducats by being here, because it's 10% boost on the 32 of the base. It's very complicated. So I hope that makes sense. Yeah. Okay, that all having been said, we're watching to see if the Russians get enough pain out of the current war that they will not join the Ottomans. It's down to 6, it's back up to 7. Okay, we're just watching this every month as it drains away. We're hoping that our manpower will grow to like 15,000 at exactly the moment this drops to -1, and then we'll be able to go to war. They're at 412 in debt. We just keep hoping that gets worse. You know what we could do is pay off Poland's debt if we wanted to keep them in the game here. Oh, they're also at war with Lübeck. Huh. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to do that. I'm going to pay off their debt, take a loan myself. Money is not a problem for me. Oh, they're great power. We can't take on their debt. Okay. Well, then I'll just use that to do something else. Is Sweden a great power? Is Denmark a great power? They can. We can't take on their foreign debt. Who else is Russia at war with? Norway, Sweden, East Frisia, Poland, and Lithuania. East Frisia. Oh, my phone's going off here. One second. Oh, it's just telling me that more games are on sale. Okay. I can't take on foreign debt, so I'm just going to use that to improve my ships, I think. It's going to cost me 552, so let's do it. Our diplomat and the Ottomans have been discovered. Damn. All right, we're just keeping an eye on that number every month. We're hoping to hell that they start running out of money. It's down to 6. Their war exhaustion's getting higher. The only reason we have a chance at this is because the Russians actually like us. They have a friendly attitude towards us. We're going to keep that diplomat in Russia just to make sure nothing untoward happens. The other reason to wait, although, damn, Russia is really winning. The option I have here is I could go for the Ottomans, take over as much of their territory as possible, while their armies are busy elsewhere. That's something I'm considering. And use my navy to prevent them from coming back across the Black Sea. It's really not a bad plan. Do any of these have castles? Yes, one. Because if this doesn't continue to go down at a decent speed, then I'm concerned. Russia has 128,000 men. Oh my god. I mean, worst case scenario, I guess I bring France in and promise them territory. It is very disappointing if I have to do that. Military access from Denmark? Absolutely. Beat up the Russians. We believe in you. Maybe I could just give a gift to Poland. Keep them in that game. I don't need to pay off their debt. I can just give them a bunch of money. There you go. Stay alive, Poland! Stay alive! Keep draining them. Russia's currently at plus one, so they're still not close to winning it, even though they have all this territory. But if, oh, snap! Thank you, Lithuania! That's going to make this even easier. You're right, my morale boost is going to run out soon. But, I mean, the goal... Oh, it's actually 99. Oh, that's the land maintenance modifier. This is the one, 92, you're right. The goal here is going to be to fight them without having to actually, you know... fight them. But now that the Pope is called a crusade, will my allies come? No? Tuscany won't because they don't owe me favors. Austria because they like the freaking Ottomans for some reason, and Poland because they're already in war with. But that crusade against the Ottomans is great. Russia's at five. They're going down. I wish they would be in more debt. I want them to be in debt more. They're still only at plus one. They haven't taken the war goal. But as soon as they do, they'll get a ton of war score because they'll flip it against them. Oops, damn it, I keep clicking the wrong one. They're at three! They are at three, people! It's happening! Yes, their war exhaustion's going up. I just hope their debt goes up, too. That would be even better. Make that less of a problem. The Ottomans are drafting more forces. They must have hit a loss up there. After a battle. Ooh. There might be enough Poles to win this. Yeah, come on. You can do it, Poland. I believe in you. Wait a minute. Oh, that was just not enough nearly. Okay. Ooh, lose 5 prestige. That's no good. Oh, we have apparently not been doing trade this whole time. Trying to keep this unrest down. Moldovan separatists, that was the other one. All right, let's check it again. There it is! Yes! It's on a zero, though. Jesus, can I just wait one more for it to go under? Let's just wait one more for it to go to negative one. I don't want to chance it. All right, let's put this guy in a position. Then get my navy healed up. Because I forgot they're actually kind of weak right now. And the Ottoman navy is not strong, but it's not weak either. All right. Come on, come on, come on. Is it negative one? Still zero. All right. Yes, there's our discipline plus five. Good timing. And trade efficiency, trade range. We're going to hold off on that until we get our max manpower. Oh, they're already locked in doing it. Okay. One more month, then I'm doing it regardless. You know what? I'm doing it regardless right now. And what's our war goal? I think it's going to be Castoria, because that's well defended in my area. Don't need France. Thank God. Okay. The main hope here is that doesn't go back above one. In the first 30 months, right? That's the main hope. And it looks like, actually, the Ottomans just lost a big battle there along with the Russians, so they just got even more war exhaustion. Excellent. You think you're actually pinning me in there? They're just getting stronger. Give them a bit. They'll come out. Roaring, ready to go. Oh, that means that I can't cross the strait, though. Damn it. They are pinning me. All right, let's just get these guys back up mostly to full. All right, so far, so good. Oh, man! Our awesome Doge just got an extra plus 5%. Discipline and mercenary maintenance is down. What is our discipline now? 115? Jesus. Okay, we're in good shape. To that end, however, we're going to add war to our religious fervor. Although I forgot to save some administrative power for this, but we'll probably get back to that soon enough. And I will do what I normally do in these wars, which is have a single 1,000-man army designed to run around and siege all the tiny things behind us. Ooh, gain 20 army tradition? I can't say no to that. Although this is going to be a problem. Oh, Lithuania is bringing toward 30,000 reinforcements to save the day. Can they do it? Oh, wow, they're already winning. Ooh, our arrival is done. Let's get back to our spy network on the Ottomans so our sieges are faster. What is Wald State? Oh, no, I don't want some of Switzerland. Unnecessary. Don't care about loans, don't care about missions, don't care about that. Just let these ships fix themselves, and then we'll go deal with this nonsense real soon. Oh, you know what? That's awesome. But let's go do this while we're waiting for that to happen. I forgot there was another fort down here to grab. The Ottomans have some war exhaustion, but not a lot. We won the Siege of Castoria, so their war exhaustion's about to get worse. Very slowly, because it's only one tiny piece of their empire, but are they still winning this? They're losing it now! They're losing it! Awesome! Epirus is under commander occupation. Our truce with Great Britain has ended. The French still like us. The Poles still kind of like us. Austria still likes us. Your navy is doomed, sir. I hope you know that. Ooh, anything to gain 5 Republican tradition right about now. Totally worth it. Any advice for playing a major Western European power? Get good alliances with other major Western European powers. That's my advice. Okay. So, we've got that, which means we want to move our forces into position here. We're even. Although we still have this good general. I just hope he doesn't die. He's pretty old. They won't be able to cross the strait here, because I'm going to pop up and fight them, and if they do... okay, we don't need to worry about Spain anymore. I wonder, should I get some more of something? Maybe more infantry. Let's get a few more infantry for each of my forces. Just to help turn the tide. Whoa, you think you're crossing there, huh? I know that we only have 75%, but we're doing it. Oh, okay. They ran away from me regardless. So we stopped that rush across. We have control of the strait now. Wait a minute, why do I have three there? Oh, because one of those was supposed to be separated. Supposed to keep them separated, you see. This force is almost ready. Oh, they got Knight Azoff. Oh no, not Azoff. Whatever will I do? Ooh, we definitely want to flip Cairo to our religion. Alright, this is almost done. Then we can go fight them. Ooh, our siege ability is 37%. That's awesome. There we go. Okay. So, now we're going to try to deal with this. We're going to put our best leader over here sieging something. Our other leader's going to get that back, and this guy's going to get that back. I don't know where their army went. Once they realized they couldn't go across the thing, they must have gone back around over to fight with Russia, I guess? But I pulled 30,000 men away, so Poland has gotten a lot of its territory back, so that's great. Because the main thing was to not have Russia start winning and then join my war. And that is definitely not happening. So... I can tell you one of the things we're definitely going to get in this war is we're going to annul the treaty that they have with Russia. Oh, it's already been annulled because Russia refused to join. Does that mean I might be able to get an alliance with Russia right when this ends? Maybe. Oh, no, we're allied to France, so probably not. All right, we got our capital back again. Let's go get Sulga. I need to keep my forces close enough. I've got the ability to do the fast march should I need to. Uh-oh. Yep, pay that off. Yeah, we're going to start doing that. Oh, they can't make it there that way. They can't go directly there. So I guess it's much better if we do this. Alright, we're going to send our ships back to protect trade in Ragusa to increase our income, because we don't need them anymore. Our main ships are just fine doing what they're doing. But I need to make sure, if I'm sieging anything down, I have my other forces right nearby that can move in. Yes. Didn't I give you a trade mission? Oh, and then I gave him the wrong order. That's why. Oh, hang on. I did that backwards. I forgot that these guys wouldn't be able to go there. Damn it. So these guys have to be here so that they're not vulnerable. Man, this is frustrating. That fort really screws us over. So it's got to go down. Is it a bastion, though? No, it's just a regular castle, so we should be able to take it. All right, we can finally make that other thing a core. I'm a little concerned about these, but that's not a concern for quite a while. Okay. Wow, they have even more people. Whoa, they have 17 cannons? I guess we're going to want at least 16, won't we? Oh, I'm running out of money. Okay, well, let's do that then. We'll grow more cannons out of the ground. Breached the walls. Yeah, they got Huda Vendigar again. But that's okay. In the long run, I've got these territories under my control that are going to constantly increase their war exhaustion. And once I get these extra cannons, I'm pretty sure... Oh, boy. They're trying for it. Okay, so 115 versus 110, 6.3 versus 5.1, and 2.3 versus 2.2. I'm winning on all accounts, except I've got the terrain penalty here. Good numbers, good numbers. Whoa, some of them already left. Victory is mine. I didn't even get those extra cannons. But the cannons are coming. That'll make things better. Ooh, maximum monarch power available. So let's get our diplomatic technology, I guess. No, let's get one more round of mercantilism, and then we'll get it next year when we don't have... We get 10% more. Defenders deserted. Whew, this is tricky. They definitely outnumber me. Where's my force limit? I'm not quite near my force limit, but I'm building another four guys here, so that'll put me even closer. Booyah! Okay, we have a lot of options now. We seem to be winning this fairly handily. Has it been 30 months yet? Looks like it might be close. That means nobody can join in, hopefully. Oh, we'll keep this guy again. He's given us lots of good power. Oh boy. They're coming back. And I'm going to lose that 1,000 because I changed his direction. But he was doomed if he went the other way anyway. What to do now? We got that fort. That was part of the key. He's going for that, huh? If we move swiftly enough, we might be able to intercept him. Nope, he's running away. Not quite. Actually, we no longer need the super swift, costly movement. Although, if I go here, he'll have the advantage. Ugh. Aha! I've trapped him over there now. With my boats. And he's on my territory. He'll be forced over here, and I can maybe chase him down and kill him. Oh no, he won't be forced over there. He can't go over there. He might be able to annihilate his whole army. This might have been a very bad move for him. As long as I can win this battle. I'm not sure if he'll be able to go past Constantinople. So hang on here. I said hang on. Okay, good. Yes, I do have... So it's 29. 5, 6, 7, 8, but only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Why are there only 21,000? There should be a lot more infantry on this thing. Like, at least in the back, waiting to join, but that's weird. Ah! They're gone! Ha-ha! Defeated! As I mentioned, big mistake getting themselves trapped over there by the boats. This is happening again. Bingo. Okay, we'll take that. Trade efficiency increased, blah, blah, blah. These are the things I want. Mamluks, Ottomans, Karaman, Hejaz, Iraq, Tunis. Eh, whatever. We'll also want them to be humiliated. Although that's a lot for me to core. So maybe I'll take everything except that. And then instead take some extra money from war reparations. There we go. Now we just need to finish it. Damn, it's already lunchtime. It's going to take them a long time to build up enough forces to come back and challenge me. Wow, actually, no, it's not. They've got 30,000 over there already wrecking me. What the hell? We could ask our French ally to let us move through their territory. Yes, he's good. Well, I think we may have just... Nope, not quite trapped him. Yeah, we got hit with those big penalties. Damn it. They just keep coming up with more men. They're running out, though. 9,000 left. Russia's still at war, but it looks like all of the provinces that were occupied are gone, which is interesting. I guess we'll win that anyway. Run away! We're gonna be able to pull the same trap. It doesn't look like it. But I think if we can conquer Sulga before he conquers here, then we can wrap up behind and get him. This is the one that's stopping us from easily moving through here, just like this one used to be. Getting control of those helps us in the maneuver game. To that end, let's send our extra 8 cannon in here to make this happen faster. Damn, he got extra lucky. Damn it. All right, but he is moving across there, which is, again, gonna... Well, it's not gonna trap him if... Well, yeah, it might, actually. There we go. France is at war with who? Savoy, Wurzburg, a bunch of people we don't care about. All right, we trapped his 30,000 back there again. Oh, where did that 30,000 come from? Out of nowhere! And then they ran away. They bravely ran away. And I think we'll wipe this 30,000 out as well. Oh wow, they were all infantry. They had no cavalry or cannons in that. Couldn't afford it, maybe. Where are the Ottomans? They fell off the list? Well, that's because it was ordered by total, not by force limit. There we go. They still got 30,000. Ooh, military tech improvements. Finally, training fields will help our manpower situation. I'm gonna build one in whichever place helps us the most. 1125. Yeah, for some reason that is the highest. We pumped a lot in there. There's still 30,000 more here. That took a while. He's still getting his army back. Where's our money going now? We're losing money. Trade is still big income, so we haven't lost income anywhere. We're paying a little bit of interest. Our advisors are still very high. We could raise war taxes in a minute and help deal with this. Ooh, really? 15,000 versus 33,000? How smart is that? Oh, the rest of them joined just in time. I think we're still gonna win. We have so many cannons. Oh, but then we rolled really badly. Oh, God. We still got it. Jesus, that was bloody, though. They still lost way more than we did. They still have way more than we do. How is that possible? Interest per annum would be very nice right about now. But I'd rather get this production efficiency. Finally got that back. Except where's this guy? Select. Merchant. I'll take the diplomatic power hit. And I'm going to try to blockade more of their territory. How close are we to getting what we want? I mean, we want maybe too much. But I need them to suck. They need to stop being what they are, which is too damn big. Okay, speed it up a little bit. I'm a bit concerned they're gonna come out of here with another giant force, and I'm not having reinforce all my guys. I'm 10,000 short, actually. So I need 2 and 1. Jesus, yeah, there they are. Back again. And 4 and 1. Not gonna stop us. What was that? Another not so important thing. All right. Hopefully he gives us a moment to catch our breath since our manpower's gone. Oh! What the hell? Stupid particularists? That's the wrong time to rise up. We don't have an embargo against them yet, huh? Somehow we were kind of winning, and now we're not. I really don't want to leave this Fargan. We still won it somehow. Oh, God. We can't even siege anything down. They come back with a force twice as big as ours every time. I don't know if we're going to win this one. Looks like we might just... Reinforce and manpower recovery speed? Thank you. That is definitely something we could have used right there. Okay. So I'm going to do what I've been meaning to do. It's 14, 4, and 8 so far, right? All right, so we have plenty of artillery here, basically. But not nearly enough anything else. We're supposed to have 28 infantry. And one more cavalry. All right, so that's 12. 15. So we're actually short 21. There we go. All of that together should rebuild my armies to their former levels, made purely out of mercenaries. Have a leader still in charge? Yeah, our good guy's still involved there. We still dealt more to them than they did to us. Oh, and they got kicked across the ocean there. Okay, so, that having taken care of, let's see if we can siege. Oh, they've got another fucking army. How are they doing this? We've taken all of their territory over here from the beginning of the damn game. I just need to know. I can't let them have that, though. All right, so that's my one army, that's my two army, and that's my three army, and now they're almost entirely composed of mercenaries. Yeah, I might be getting close to the point of quitting while I'm ahead. You're not wrong. What can I avoid getting and still... That's pretty close. If I avoid getting the war reparations, then I'll be okay. It's still ticking in my favor here. Yes, one more bit. He's running away. He bravely ran away. Yeah, I guess I'll take what I can get. The territory is most important, so... There it is. Unfortunately, I don't have an awful lot of ability to core these. But we also have this problem here with my Republican tradition hitting the limit. Biga has just joined the state club. Because it was part of the group here. I could turn that into a trading city to reduce my issue. This actually is definitely was the plan to become a trading city, because it's useless to me. But this way it's not composed of my enemies. And I'm almost certainly never going to get Burgess. I will, however, get this added. So which of these do I want to be the trading city, and which do I want... I think they want this to eventually be the trading city, so I don't need to worry about adding that to a trading city at the moment. So let's make this one go away, because it's not necessary. The other ones I'm probably just going to keep around, because I'm feeling that we're going to have an issue with uprising sometime soon. Let's get rid of 2,000 from each, now that we don't have to fight a giant, giant army. We'll probably be okay with just 24,000 infantry. And in order to pay off these loans, probably need to bring down the forts for a while. All right, we're in good shape. We're still paying an awful lot for mercenaries. Although, as we determined, they are a lot less than they used to be. 0.47. Actually, they don't seem to be that much less. They should be minus 50, I thought. Mercenary maintenance minus 25. Oh, I have gotten that. Maybe it's not... Oh, it's compounding, I bet. So it's minus 25 from their current, not minus 25 from their total. So it's not like it's 50% off the total. Anyway, it's better than it used to be. That bonus discipline helped us a lot. And even though we won that, we didn't take much from them. In the end. The good news is that they're not allied with Russia anymore. I don't think we can ally with Russia. No, not as long as we're allied to Poland and France. But the next time we go against the Ottomans, maybe the French will have enough favors for us. Yeah, we're a little closer now. The Austrians are only useful to defend against Bohemia being a douche, or France being a douche. So the next attack is going to have to be against the Mamluks in 3 years. So we'll have to be ready for that. Even though we have some loans we have to pay back. $1,500 worth. Well, it is what it is. After Biga becomes a core, we'll be getting a little bit more. I mean, our manpower is slowly getting bigger. There we go, 520 per month is much better. I don't understand why we don't have a lot more somewhere. Milan is already working to change its culture. Six, this is really the highest manpower one we have anywhere in Verona. Let's increase the barracks here. There we go. That'll help a little bit. Because I did finish my ideas, right? Yeah, I finished offensive ideas, so I don't have to worry too much about military tech anymore. So I can afford to spend to upgrade it some places. Yearly prestige for the cost of money. Our prestige is really high. Let's say no to that. All right, so now we have even more control here. We're getting a little bit more control there. Although that seems to be identical to what it used to be. Jeez, Genoa and France are pulling all the stuff from here. Hungary is still the main concern. Oh no. Austria, why do you do this? You make it so hard to love you, Austria. Ravensburg is allied. See, it says Ravensburg is allied with the Palatinate. But every time I looked over here, it didn't seem like it. Yeah, it is. Okay. And you know that that means... Although the Palatinate should not be able to call in its own allies unless it's being called in as... Unless Austria is also declaring war on the Palatinate. Let's just wait a moment and see who else joins this war before we join. Because if this is it, I'll totally join and help Austria finally rid itself of this nonsense. And it looks like that's really it. They might... Oh, jeez. How did Bohemia get pulled in? They're not an ally with them! God damn it. That makes zero sense. Is Austria declaring on the Palatinate as well as Ravensburg? Hmm. Well, I can't afford to get drawn into any of this nonsense anymore, Austria. I just can't. I don't know how Bohemia keeps coming in, unless... No, they're not even a great power. Yeah, we're gonna leave Austria to their fate, because they're idiots. They're not even useful to us anymore, because they're not the emperor. So they don't get all the power that they normally got when they're the emperor. Instead, Tuscany is our new friend. Savoy could be a new friend, right? Except that they hate us. With a passion. Holy crap. But anyway. We'll just be happy if... Oh good, Farah's going to get pulled into Tuscany, and Tuscany's going to get a little stronger. I don't mind if Tuscany gets a little stronger. Ooh. Wow, Bohemia's 1,000 in debt. It keeps getting pulled in there anyway. All right, I think it's time to stop for lunch, guys. I will come back in about an hour or so. And we'll ignore Austria and pursue our goals down here. The Mamluks will fall even further behind. Are they still considered a great power? They aren't. Persia's taken that slot. But we'll grab a bunch more Mamluk territory, which will continue to strengthen us, which will maybe allow us to take on the Ottomans again with a slightly larger force next time. Still don't know how the Ottomans have such a large force limit. They have offensive and quantity ideas, those bastards. And their Ottoman ambitions are plus 33%. So even though we've taken a ton of their territory, they still have a massive force limit and massive manpower. All right, well, it is what it is. We can keep lowering it. Poland might join us in a war against the Ottomans. Right, Poland? Well, not when they're having a truce with the Ottomans and destabilization and in debt, but they would otherwise join us in a war against the Ottomans. So if we let the truce go away and Poland gets out of their debt, then we might be able to pull Poland to help us out because they owe us a lot of favors. All right. There you go. See you in a bit, guys.